Oi!
Put that light out. Well, come on, then. Give us one.
Get your own.
Oi, not so fast, love. Mrs. T, hold your horses.
What's she pushing? Ow! Where's she going? You daft owls!
Your place or mine? Plenty of chips. Lovely.
Are you in here?
Tick, 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 tick.
What's that?
Tick.
It's her.
Tick, tick, tick.
Not that. That. Mrs. Tachyon!
No, oh, it's too late!
Tuck.
Hush, 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 here comes the boogeyman. Don't let him come too close to you, he'll catch you if he can. Say shoo, shoo, and stick him with a pin. Man will very nearly jump out of his skin. Hush, 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 here comes the bogeyman.
The alien and, like, five orcs.
Five orcs?
Right, and six orcs, whatever. And that flying thing from Apar, right? Who do you reckon I'd win?
That's stupid.
You're stupid, you don't know the answer. Hey, Big Mac! Big Mac. What is it?
Lord of Ceylan. 1968.
Yeah, nice. Listen, Predator, alien, six orcs, or the flying thing from Apar. Which one?
Predator.
No way! Alien! Yes! Super strength, acid blood, end of. Hey! Do you want to hear a joke?
You don't know any.
I know loads.
Not new ones.
This piece of string goes onto a pub, right?
Heard it.
You haven't?
We've all heard it. Anyway, the flying thing from Harry Potter, it's not even real.
Oh, yeah. Like the Predator's real. You're lame. I mean, check this out. It's the wrong way round, dude. You know what I'm saying? You just ain't cool.
Wobbler, the day I need star counselling from you.
What about the orcs, Yoles? They're not real. And how many orcs do you know?
Wait, I know one. Big Mac's sister's an orc.
Better than being a fat was.
Shut up!
Make me fat was.
Shh. Listen.
What is it?
Go on, Wob. See what it is?
Get off!
Come on, then. You think you're hard, you know?
It's coming from over there.
Where?
Under those bags. See?
There's someone under there. What do you reckon they're doing?
Well, they're not sunbathing. Come on.
What are these made of? It's like rubber or something.
don't know. What do you reckon's in them?
Look who it is.
Oh, no! It's Tacky Nora! She might be dead.
Mrs. Tachyon? Mrs. Tachyon, are you all right?
Oi! Put that light out! What, no bananas? I said cocoa! Tick, tick, bang!
Well, at least we know she ain't dead.
She's passed out again.
What now?
I know. We should try the kiss of life. Where are you going?
See ya. Wouldn't want to be here.
Oh, come on, don't be stupid. We can't just leave her here. We've got to do something. Big Mac, give us your phone.
Thank you very much, Baker. All right.
Johnny Maxwell, the lad himself. Poison Ivy, Johnny boy. You can look, but you better not touch, okay? Well, I said to him, Mr. Chambers should pay for this as well, sir.
Where'd she give you? Oh, that is rough, man. It's a dinner.
She's a tall minger. Sack it, man, bin it. Come on. We'll miss the bus.
What about all this?
What about it?
Well, it's her stuff. It might be all she's got.
So? You'll be doing her a favour.
Come on, Johnny. You don't want us to miss the last bus. And what, 3 miles? Pushing a crappy old trolley full of...
crap?
I don't think so.
Come on.
All right. You go if you want. I'll do it.
See ya.
Wouldn't want to be you.
There you are. I was worried. Where have you been?
Pictures. Missed the bus. Sorry.
Your dad called. He can't make it tomorrow. Will next week be all right? What's that?
Nothing. Fish and chips.
Fish and chips? No wonder you missed bus. Who puts fish and chips in newspaper? Ooh, that is disgusting. They want chucking out.
It's all right. I'll do it.
Mum,
do you know Mrs. Tachin?
Well, Tacky Nora. She's not still around, is she? She must be 1,000.
She got hurt tonight. Someone beat her up.
Oh, that's awful. Poor soul. She was around when I was a girl. She was ancient then. Is she going to be all right?
Think so. The ambulance came. Mum, do you know where she lives?
No, love, sorry, not a clue. We always thought that she lived rough. She just sort of popped up. I remember her trolley had this squeaky wheel. You could always hear it coming.
You still can.
Well, let's hope she's not been too badly hurt, eh? Right, well, I'm off to bed. Don't forget to say goodnight to your granddad. He's waiting up for you. And will you get rid of those chips? They absolutely stink. Night, love.
Night, Mum.
Good film?
Not bad. What are you watching?
Don't know. It's all rubbish. You know your dad cried off, useless git. No son of mine, I'm ashamed of him. What's that you've got?
Found it. Thought it might be good for history. School, you know.
Blackberry Blitz. Looks like new.
Photocopy, maybe. I don't know.
Jerry's Blitz Blackberry, May 21st, 1941. The night Paradise Street copped it. What a blur. Look! That's us. That's me. Your Grandma Rose. Well, she lived in Paradise Street before we were married. Look here, Skip is right. Not one person killed. Ooh, what a night, eh? I tell you, John, if you lived to be 100, you'd never know what we went through. Thank God, eh? It was life or death in them days.
What time is it?
8:30.
Is Dad coming?
No, next week, remember.
Come on, you. You can go to judo.
Mum, you know when Dad left, do you ever think, what if we went back to, like, the day before? Maybe things would turn out different.
No, they wouldn't. Things like that, it don't happen in a single day. What's done's done. Ancient history. Now, get up, you. Come on. You're going to make me late.
Well, say you could go back. How would you know what to choose?
Will you get up?
Say you went back.
Here. I've left you money by the phone.
And you could change anything.
What are you talking about?
Going back in time, before something happened. How would you know what to change?
Sorry, love. You've lost me.
See, you're trying to make it better, but you choose the wrong thing. You might make it worse. It's worrying, isn't it?
No, it's not. It's stupid. Don't worry about it. Honestly, love, it's not worth it. Now, come here. Give us a kiss. Oh, and see if your granddad needs anything before you go out. All right, and after judo, don't go missing. Come straight home and see if he's all right. Have you got that? God, I'm late. Right, I'll see you later.
Bye, love. See you, Tom. Granddad?
Hey up, lad. You off out?
Mum said she left me some judo money, but I can't find it.
Oh. I'll give it to you. How much is it?
You don't have to. £3.50.
Yeah. Go on, you're all right.
Thanks, Granddad.
Here. Hey, Grand. Come here. Look at this. That's me in the Home Guard, young slip of a lad. The Knight of the Blitz. Why should Britain tremble, eh? Yeah. The Adder's on top of Blackberry Hill, looking out for the bombers.
Did you kill any Germans?
No, not with that. Doesn't work, never fired a shot.
So why'd you keep it then?
Well, somebody gave it to me, long time ago.
Were you scared? You know, when you were a lookout?
No, most of the time we were bored. But they gave us these, see?
Cards? You played cards?
Pictures on the back, see? On the back. All the aircraft, so we could learn the difference between ours and theirs.
Cool idea.
Lousy idea. Once you learned them, you knew what the cards were. All the lads cheated, never had a decent game. What do you think?
I think they're brilliant.
Go on, they're yours. Mind you look after them, eh?
Yamayuki! Shutake, very good, Kirsty.
Did you hear about Takinara? Mum's on duty when they brought her in. She's been beaten up. Isn't that terrible?
Yamayuki!
Mum says I should be locked up. Stinky bars do stuff like that. Mind you, what was an old woman doing wandering the streets? I mean, that can't be right, can it?
Here my girl.
We should do something to help her, don't you reckon? So what could we do?
We can visit her, maybe. Take her a present.
What can you do?
That's a very good idea.
visitors for you, Mrs. Tachyon. 10 minutes now. Just not to get excited.
Maybe she's got a concussion. No, I'd say this is normal. I think she might be feeling better. We've brought you a present, Mrs. Tachyon. Something nice.
Present? Here today and gone yesterday. What present?
Chips. We've brought you some chips.
You mean you did? This has got to be so not allowed.
She likes them. You like them, don't you?
Hey, what? Don't you worry. Right as rain and twice as ninepence. Tick, tick, bang. Like to see them try. I remember it was all feels, but would they listen? Here, Johnny, you got my trolley. Well, you look after it. Them bags is special. Tick, tick, bang. Put that light out, don't you know, Zavorum? Bags of time. Yes, indeed, bags and bags of time. Gotta be believed to be seen, Johnny boy. And remember, where your mind goes, the rest of you's bound to follow. You can look, but you better not touch. Poison ivy. Poison ivy.
Late at night, while you're sleeping, poison ivy comes a creeping around.
Measles will make you bumpy, and mumps will make you bumpy. Things completely off her head. It's so sad. If I ever get that old, I just hope somebody shoots me. Don't worry, they'll be selling tickets.
Oh, you never knew, did you? Just a baby when she died. Well, you missed a treat. She was an angel, your grandma. An angel sent from heaven.
Why'd you keep this one?
Because that's a girl I fell for, the love of my life. A childhood sweethearts, Rose Bushell and me.
Who's that she's talking to?
Stop. That's some poor old biddy. What do we call her? Tachyonora, that was it. Yeah, my Rose always had a kind word for her. That was your grandma. She talked to anyone.
How long ago was this taken?
Had to be, what, 1941?
Same year as the Blitz?
Yeah, we were both 16. Yeah, Tachyonora had some sort of trolley. Yeah, one of the wheels squeak, you could always hear it coming.
Do you mind telling me what we're doing?
I want to show you something.
It was us who found her. She was in the alley behind the multiplex with all the bags on top of her. We had to pick them off, but they seemed sort of... well, different. See what I mean?
No, trust me. These are regular, disgusting bin bags.
Don't touch them.
Do I look crazy? I wasn't going to touch them. They're gross. She's probably been pushing them around for like a million years.
When we found her, she had this. Her fish and chips were wrapped in it.
And I'm not touching that either.
But look at the date. See? May 1941. It's over 60 years old. Kirsty, I don't think Miss Tachyon was mugged. Whatever happened to her, I think had something to do with this. Or with these. Mrs. Tachyon was already old when my mum was a girl.
Okay.
Plus which, she's in a photo taken of my grandma in 1941. And she's old then. I mean, how does that work out?
What do you reckon's inside then?
You can look, but you better not touch.
What?
Nothing. I don't know, that song Mrs. Tachyon was singing.
What do you think you're doing? Get off there, young hooligan. That's still wet.
You disappeared.
I don't know. I was outside somewhere and this guy was shouting at me and I don't know.
You totally disappeared.
Maybe you just thought I disappeared.
So you're saying I don't know the difference between thinking and doing? OK, well, this is me thinking about a work end home.
And this is me doing it. You disappeared.
Kirsten, look.
Talk to the walls, because I ain't listening.
Look! Wherever I went to, the garage wasn't built yet. There were no walls. The floor was still wet.
You're talking about time travel, yeah? Which is, like, impossible.
Careful. Can look, but you better not touch, all right?
Poison ivy, poison ivy.
So, Johnny reckons this is a time machine?
Hands off, stinky boy. I'm saying nothing.
Ah, a Tesco time machine. For, like, jumping checkout queues.
I know what I know.
Which is?
Nothing. I'm sworn to secrecy.
Don't tell me, don't tell me. Queen of Hearts. 7 of Clubs.
Okay, how are you doing it?
Sorry, Wob. It's a military secret. If I told you that, I'd have to kill you.
This one.
Easy. Ace of Diamonds.
Hey, Big Mac. The show-off martial arts know-it-all hell creature thinks sacking on his trolley is a time machine.
What have you been saying?
Nothing!
We don't know for sure.
So what's in them? The bin bags, what's in them?
We don't know.
We haven't looked.
They haven't even looked? Go on, open them up. I dare you.
Yeah, go on. Open up, Johnny. Whoa! Careful. It's probably full of, like, a zillion pairs of crusty old knickers. Landed on my phone. I think it's busted.
What's the Spitfire doing here?
Well, I was here anyway.
This is another lame weirdo Johnny Maxwell trick. Come on, how did you do it?
Where are we?
You know when people say, I remember when this was all fields? Well, I think I remember when that was all buildings.
You remember? You're saying that's Blackberry.
Hey, anyone hear a joke?
But like years ago, before they built all the new stuff.
This piece of string walks into a pub, right?
Shut up, Wobbler!
How many years ago?
I don't know. I told you, the trolley's a time machine.
Nice one, bro. You'll get the only time machine with no clock on it.
All I was thinking about Spitfires.
Just my luck. Lost in time with 4 token boys.
Hey, we didn't ask to be here.
You were touching the trolley.
Suppose it's a mercy there's no pet dog called Toto.
OK, I'm going to give you one last chance. Who wants to hear a joke?
Shoot, Wobbler!
Right, that's it.
Where you going, man?
Home!
Oh, come back, Wob. Tell us a joke if you like.
Get stuffed.
Fool. You don't even know where home is.
Yeah, well, neither do we. Come on, how do we get back?
I don't know. It just sort of happens. Suddenly you're back where you were.
Unless, of course, someone's built a block of flats, in which case you end up with your hands sticking out of a concrete wall.
Don't listen to her. Stay cool. We have to find someone we recognise. Someone hasn't changed. Come on. What's not to like? There's nothing here.
My point exactly, bro. No cars. What kind of people don't have cars? I mean, natural.
Look, Paradise Street. This is where my gran lives, where she used to live.
Are they open?
Can't tell. There's no light on.
Mm-hmm.
Earth to Johnny, what's up? You look like you've seen a ghost.
That's her. That girl. Her name's Rose. Kirsty, she's my grandma.
That is very weird. Are you sure? I have to find out. Whoa, not so fast. Maybe you should wait here and look after the trolley.
Hey, why me?
Let's just say these are probably nice, decent people.
And one look at you, we'll have them calling the cops.
Gotta be said.
Suits me. I'd rather stay out here anyway.
Did you want something?
That girl who was in here just now.
Young Rose? What about her?
Nothing. I thought I knew her, that's all. Does she live round here?
Down the street, number 12. Was there anything else?
Yeah. Do you have any local papers, please?
That pile in the corner.
Thanks.
See all sorts these days. But I've never seen a lass in trousers before. Are you foreign?
No. No, we're English.
Well, you're not from around here. You've been evacuated?
Not exactly. We're, like, visiting.
I see. So, Sambo's with you, is he?
Sorry?
Little darky lad is with you?
Yeah. Yeah, he's with us.
Oh, yes, that's me. I'm with the white children.
Oh, bless him. Don't he speak good English?
Oh, sure does. I only need the very best missionaries.
He's a laugh, isn't he? How much?
Threepence.
Johnny, pay the nice lady.
What's threepence?
Oh, don't worry, I'm closing soon. I won't be selling any more.
Thanks.
Oh, yes. Thank you kindly, ma'am.
Come on. Just read it over here, is that all right?
See the crescent, please.
See the crescent? Sorry, I don't. Mildred, do you know of a see the crescent?
It's gotta be here somewhere. It's got a massive great conker tree on the corner.
Well, I've just planted that one. Well, I'll give it a good 60 odd years before you get any decent conkers.
And Stone Avenue, Hatton Hill Road, Seely Crescent.
This is Twyford Crescent. Look, son, I'm Councillor Seely. If we had a crescent named after me, I think I'd know about it, don't you? You're not from round here, are you?
Yeah. I mean, I thought I was. I don't know.
What's your name, son?
Walter. Walter Bailey.
Well, I'm pleased to meet you, Walter. That's a fine name. I've got a brother called Walter. He's out fighting in Africa.
Is he? Why?
He's with the desert rats. He's off fighting Rommel.
Look at the date, May 21st, 1941.
That's over 64 years ago.
No, but May 21st is the day of the Blackberry Blitz.
Are you sure?
Stop it.
I know. There's a war on. I shouldn't leave her running. We've no idea how long it took to get her started. Tell you what.
Echo, is it?
Yes.
What are you doing? I'm not doing anything. Sir, she's a racist.
No, she's not. We're in olden times. They didn't have racists then.
She called me Sambo.
So, don't take it personally. This is a great opportunity for you to study ancient culture.
I managed to get you some of those pear drops you like. I'll get them in a second.
would you? I'll settle up on, crying out loud.
My car! I say! I say stop! Stop, please!
Stop,
you
Nick.
Stop that man!
Look out!
You
stand up straight.
Easy does it, Constable. He might be in shock.
He very soon will be.
Now then, the doctor's quite right. Watch me carefully, laddie. How many fingers?
Which one?
One. Very good. Who's the Prime Minister?
Tony Blair.
Show some respect. You're talking about Winston Churchill.
Oh. Winston Churchill? Correct. Nothing wrong here, sir.
More than can be said for my car. Come on, let's take him in.
For an accident? I didn't mean it.
What's happening? Where are you taking him?
Are these friends of yours?
Johnny, they're arresting me. Do something.
With a cart full of stolen goods, I shouldn't wonder.
No, you've got it all wrong.
You speak when you're spoken to, Sonny Jim.
Sonny Jim?
In it together, if you ask me. The whole lot of them. They look foreign.
Listen. Listen, I can explain.
No, you can't. I think it's time for the old Shazam. On a count of three. One, two, three!
Suspects fleeing the scene. Do your duty, Constable.
Hey, don't leave me.
That's it, Sunshine. You're nicked.
You let him go.
You too, my lad. You're both under arrest.
Sorry. I hate it when she does that.
Come on, Johnny.
You're not in a concrete wall.
Sagna, get off me.
Excuse me. What happened to... Thank you, Kirsty, for saving my sorry ass.
Did I ask to get stuck in olden times? With a bunch of weird racists?
At least they knew you were a boy.
I was upset. Don't worry about it.
I'm not. Big Mac and Wobble have got the problem, not him.
We'll go back for them. We've got to.
Right. Let's get on with this, shall we?
I thought you were a doctor.
I thought you were a doctor, sir.
I am. I'm also Captain Geoffrey Harris of His Majesty's Home Guard. Now, who might you be?
Big Mac, Blackberry Skins, kicking ass. Check it out, yeah?
He's a spy. You mark my words.
What exactly do you mean by Blackberry Skins?
That's me, Basil and Skaz. We're skinheads. It's a kind of gang.
A gang?
He's got this sort of Japanese thing, I mean. Not to mention this murderous lethal weapon.
All right, keep your wig on. It's only a Swiss Army knife.
And are you in the Swiss Army?
Get real. Of course not.
No. He's in the German Army. Look at this, sir. Vorsprung Dirk Technik. If that's not German, I'm a Dutchman.
You're in very serious trouble, you know that, don't you? Quite apart from stealing my motor car.
Sack that, I never...
Let's just start at the beginning, shall we? Name?
Simon. Simon Wrigley. Sir.
Do you think everyone's a racist?
Oh, yeah? What about that lady in the shop?
Oh, them signs are different. She wasn't a real racist. She was just how people were back then.
Did she call you Sambo? No, I don't think she did.
No, but she didn't mean it. You know, nastily. It was just the way she was brought up.
Hang on a minute. I've got to see if my granddad's all right.
Sure, cool. I mean, honestly, Olis, you people, you expect everyone to rewrite history for you.
You people? You people? My granddad came here in 1942.
Yeah, whatever.
That's it, I'm not talking to you. You know something? We should have left you in olden times, because that's where you belong.
You're talking to me?
Not anymore, girl. That's it. The last time ever.
Hey, Grandad.
Thank you.
Mr. Maxwell, good morning. I'd like to have a word with young Johnny, if I may.
Johnny, no, you've got it wrong. No Johnny living here.
But you are Mr. Maxwell. Mr. Tom Maxwell? Well, I'm looking for your grandson, Johnny. Johnny Maxwell.
I've got no grandson. I've got no children.
I'm sorry, there must be a mistake.
There is, mate, and you've made it. I'm on my own, always have been. The only woman I've ever loved was killed in the war more than 60 years ago, and if you don't mind, I've got to close the door.
Different. My room's gone.
Your room's gone?
Not gone. It's full of old stuff. Like a storeroom. My granddad just told this guy at the door he doesn't even have a grandson. Doesn't even know anyone called Johnny.
A vague sense of impending doom.
Where are you going? See Mrs. Tackian. See if she knows what's going on.
Would that be the Mrs. Tackian who's in hospital singing to the walls?
I don't think so.
We're going to do something, Kirsty. Nothing feels right. What's this?
Johnny Maxwell, I want a word with you.
Come on.
Sorry, sir. They seem to have got away.
Don't worry, we'll find them. Believe me, Johnny Maxwell has nowhere to go.
Go back in time, and you change something.
What are you talking about?
Going back in time. See, you're trying to make it better. But you choose the wrong thing. You might make it worse.
What happens then?
Oh, don't worry about it. Honestly, it's not worth it. He's always dropping it. Thanks. Sorry, do I know you?
Mum. Mum, it's me, Johnny.
What's going on? Everything OK?
Who's he?
Oh, mind who I am. Who are you? Hey!
Dead. That can't be right. No one was killed. Granddad said he definitely said it was lucky no one was killed.
Feel everything is slipping and a sliding, eh, Johnny? Mind if I sit down? I take it Big Mac and Wobbler won't join us. Excuse me. Did you get as far as the list of casualties? Ah, here we are. Mrs. Maisie Bushell and her daughter Rose. Tragic. Both killed, apparently.
But that can't be right. Rose is your gran, isn't she? How can she die?
She couldn't. He's lying. You're lying. You're making it up.
And why are you following us?
I'm not following you. I was here first. Has anyone heard of the butterfly effect?
Is that when you step on a butterfly and thousands of years later it turns out you've started World War III?
Little causes have big effects. Very good, Kirsty. You always were a little know-it-all.
Sure!
Now, listen. When you travel in time, you make changes. You don't mean to, but you can't help it. The changes mount up. Johnny used to have a grandmother, but what can I say? Here today, gone yesterday.
What are you saying? If I never had a grandmother,
that at me like I don't exist or something?
Are you saying he doesn't exist?
Afraid not. Not anymore. At least, not in this life.
We didn't mean to. We didn't do anything.
You left Big Mac and Wobbler behind. They're still there in 1941, causing ripples, making waves.
I just want everything back the way it was.
Well, of course you do, and I can help. But to get everything back the way it was, you'll have to start at the place where everything went wrong. Let me give you a clue. The night of the Blitz, the siren should have sounded, but there was a storm, and for some reason, it didn't go off. Now, did you or your friends have anything to do with that? Think about it.
No. I don't know. How could we?
Think carefully.
I don't know. This is all a big game to you, isn't it? And guess what? I don't want to play.
Johnny, I'm disappointed in you. Where's your sense of adventure?
Hey! What are we supposed to do?
Go back. Find Big Mac and Wobbler. You'll work it out. I have faith in you.
Great. Thanks.
And Johnny, if you are going back, close. Maybe something a little less conspicuous.
Quick! Where your mind goes, the rest of you is bound to follow.
Like they're doing Star Trek.
We've travelled through a singularity, Yolus, a gap in the space-time continuum. It's bound to have a randomising effect on our mode of re-entry.
What are you talking about? That doesn't make any sense. You're showing off.
OK, well, let's make it simple for you. This is real and Star Trek's not real, so get over it.
Oh, yeah? Well, you want to know what's not real? You, in that frock.
Back off, both of you. Got important stuff to do.
Whereabouts are we? Is this the community centre?
Like it used to be in the past. Must have been a chapel.
How far in the past?
Oh, no, let me think. May 21st, 1941, at about 5:30. Duh, get there quicker, Yolus.
This can't be right. The community centre's on a new housing estate.
It's because Paradise Street doesn't exist in our time. It gets bombed at 9 o'clock tonight.
And all those people will be killed.
And it's all our fault.
How? How is it our fault? What have we done that was so terrible?
Somehow we stopped the air raid siren going off. Maybe Wobbler did it, or Big Mac. I don't know. There she is.
She's gonna die. Don't give me the evil eye, stinky boy. I know this is weird stuff, but it's not my weird stuff, OK?
Tom!
And who's that? Your granddad?
Yeah, I think so.
So what are we waiting for? Why don't we go tell them about the Blitz? At least then you'll be able to get born.
Wait, Kirsty, we've got to think about this. You can't just go around changing stuff. You might make things worse.
Worse? How worse? What's worse than getting bombed?
What about Big Mac and Wobbler? I thought we were going to go and find them first.
Listen. You two look for Big Mac, find the police station. They can't keep him there forever, can they? Then we'll meet back here and we'll all look for Wobbler.
And what about you?
This is something I have to do on my own.
But
please.
So what are you going to say? Trust me, I'm like your grandson from 60 years in the future.
I don't know. I'll think of something.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Come on, let's find the police station.
Then what?
I don't know, I'll think of something.
Very good of you to give us a hand, Walter.
Oh, that's all right.
Won't those friends you were looking for be wondering where you are?
No, to be honest, I don't like them much.
Hey, I'll tell you what, when we're finished here, we'll get Mildred to do us a bit of tea. You'll do that for us, won't you, Mildred? How does that sound?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, no, no, it's only fair. A labourer is worthy of his hire. That's in the Bible, Walter. Wigan Warriors? Who's Wigan Warriors when they're at home?
Well, the rugby league side.
Well, I've been following rugby league for 25 years, and I knew it, not me. What about this coat? A bit of a bobby dazzler, isn't it? What's it made of?
Nylon, I think.
Nylon? That's one of them newfangled American inventions, isn't it? You're not a Yank, are you?
No, Hey, do you want to hear a joke?
Ah, go on then, I could always use a laugh.
This piece of string walks into a pub, right?
A piece of string?
Have you heard it?
No, I don't think so. I'm just starting to imagine it.
Anyway, he goes into this pub and the barman says, are you a piece of string? Because we don't serve pieces of string. And the piece of string says, no, I'm afraid not. It's like afraid not, but it's like afraid not.
Oh, yeah. Afraid not. That's very good, that, yeah. It's like surreal, isn't it, yeah? Yeah. I must remember that, Walter, yeah. Have you got any more?
Are you serious?
What are you looking at?
Is your name Rose? Rose Bushell?
Who wants to know?
I'm Johnny. Can I talk to you?
It's free country.
I've got something really important to tell you. Can I come in?
No.
What's that?
It's the air raid siren.
Can't be. It's too early. It's not supposed to work. Something terrible's going to happen. Don't ask me how I know, but there's going to be an air raid. People in the street are going to die.
Hey, what are you talking about?
We've got to hide quickly. Where should we hide?
Don't panic. What's wrong with you?
The siren.
They're only testing it. Same as always. Gemma's not coming broad daylight. You're not from round here, are you?
No, I mean, yeah, I mean, sort of.
I think you better come inside.
It shows you how far the gems have come. This Audi thing is obviously some sort of secret weapon.
The best we could manage is your old MG. No offence, Doc. But what do you make of the date?
Yes, I've been thinking about that. It's obviously some sort of propaganda exercise designed to lower our morale, make us believe they're years ahead of the game.
Devious swine.
Oh, they'll stop at nothing, Sergeant. Any luck with the Japanese thing, eh?
No. No, sir. Just says, searching for network.
What can you see?
They're questioning him. The doctor's there. And there's a soldier guarding the door.
Is he all right?
Shh. I want to hear what they're saying.
So, tell me about this network.
It's for the phone. Keep telling you. And the phone won't work, so there ain't any signal. Tell you what, though. Give it here. I'll take a photo if you like. Say cheese.
Don't you point that thing at me, Sonny Jim.
Don't be daft. It's only a camera.
Only a camera, Sergeant?
We only have his word for that, sir.
Here, look. There, see?
I say, it's in colour.
Too clever by half.
If I had a signal, I could send that to someone.
Really? Would that be someone on the network?
Yeah, I suppose.
But first you'd need a signal.
A signal? For his network of Nazi spies, it's obvious.
I'm not a Nazi spy, I'm 15.
We've all heard about the Hitler Youth.
Look at his haircut. Look at his clothes. Not exactly a Boy Scout, are you, laddie?
No, but I'm not a spy.
Well, military intelligence can sort that out. And the boffins will want to see this little lot. Lost property cover, please, Sergeant.
They think he's a spy. They're locking his stuff away. They'll never let him go now. No way. We've got to do something. Get him out of there. Suppose they lock him in a cell. Then what? What do we do then? You've gone very quiet. You're not looking up my skirt, are you, stinky boy?
Right then. What's your game? Hey, I know you. Where's the other lad? The one who assaulted me?
Yamasuki!
No, don't believe it. You're a girl.
Believe it. Sorry.
That's it, Walter, lad. Get stuck in. You can't beat it, meeting two veg. War or no war, we don't stint on ourselves, do we, Mildred? Man, you, by the looks of you, you don't do so bad at your house. If I'm a councillor, I reckon your dad must be an MP. Hear that, Mildred? I reckon Walter's dad must be an MP.
So, Walter, love, where exactly did you say you came from?
He didn't. Now, don't pester the lad. He's having his tea. You want some more cocoa, Walter?
Oh, I'm all right. I've still got some.
Nay, lad, it'll have some skin on it, will that? Get me a fresh one, Mildred. Come on. Hey, hang on a minute, Mildred. Tell her one of them jokes you told me.
I thought he was having his tea.
Oh, it's all right. I don't mind. What do you call a man with a car number plate on his head?
I don't know. What do you call a man with a car number plate on his head?
Reg!
Reg! You know, Reg as in registration number and Reg as in Reginald. Yay! Oh, honestly, Millie.
Oh. Yes. Yes, very good.
Hang on, hang on. He's got hundreds. Tell her another one.
What to call a man with a seagull on his head?
Seagull.
Cliff.
Ah, Cliff! He's a corset, isn't he? He could be on the wireless, this lad, you know. He's got a gift.
I'm sure he has. Well, don't mind me, Walter. I'm not much good at jokes. Ted less for the both of us.
Go on. Go on, just one more.
All right, then. How to stop a bull charging?
Sorry, I don't know. How do you stop a bull charging?
Take away his credit card. Like his charge card? Get it? A little piece of plastic?
Sorry, I'm being stupid again. What's plastic?
Oh, it's like, oh, it doesn't matter. Well, this is fantastic, Mrs. Seeley. Really great. I've never had two veg before. It's a bit like cabbage and carrots, isn't it?
Well, it's nice to see a boy with a good appetite. I'll get you cocoa.
What are you looking at?
Nothing. Sorry.
There's no sugar, I'm afraid.
Why should Britain tremble, eh? Come and get your tea.
Oh, I can't, Mrs. B. I haven't got time.
You've plenty of time. Take that tin lid off and sit down.
Tom's in the home guard.
Three nights a week I give him his tea and every night he tells me he hasn't got time. Eat.
Tom's a lookout up on Blackberry Hill. Nothing bad will happen to Paradise Street while he's around. Isn't that right, Tom?
I'm just doing my bit. Same as everyone else.
If there's ever an air raid, Tom will phone the police station and Sergeant Burkle's on the siren. Easy.
What if the phones don't work? Say there was a storm. What happens then?
Well, he's not up there on his own, is he? There's Dr. Harris and old... what's his name?
Shut up, Rose. You're giving away our strength.
Johnny's all right. He's just worried about the bombing.
He's frightened like the rest of us.
We don't know him. He's not from round here. We don't know anything about him. He could be a fifth columnist.
You're not a fifth columnist, are you, son?
I don't even know what one is.
Neither do we. We've never seen one. We've just heard about them on the wireless.
Listen, if the phone's conked out, Dr. Harris would drive into town in his MG. So it's all taken care of, so there's nothing to worry about. The thought of everything.
So... your accomplices are still in the area and still assaulting my officers. I tell you, laddie, the sooner MI5 have you and your network under lock and key, the better.
I'm a young person. I know my rights. You can't keep me forever.
Well, that's where you're wrong. Simon, if that's your real name.
Haven't you heard there's a war on? We can keep you forever, unless, of course, you really are a spy.
And then we can have you shot.
What if the doctor has an unexpected breakdown?
You're a right worry guts, aren't you? It's a plan for that, Zell, isn't it, Tom?
I'm saying now, it's a military secret.
What, are you borrowing the police bike? Everyone knows, everyone's seen you.
It doesn't matter. You shouldn't talk about it. Careless talk costs lives.
I don't talk wet.
Get off. People will see.
So? I'm not ashamed. Let them see, they're only jealous.
You're brazen, you are.
I know I am. I'll see you tomorrow. When he goes on call, he takes the police bike and then he can be our last resort. So stop fretting the thought of everything. Nothing could possibly go wrong.
Cup of tea, anyone?
Aha! Excellent, old chap. Don't mind if I do. You sugared this.
Thinks Tom's wonderful. So as long as he's in the Home Guard, nothing can possibly go wrong. Where's Big Mac?
Still at the police station. We messed up. Sorry, it's my fault.
It's nobody's fault. We had another run-in with that copper. We had to leg it.
So we're right back where we started. Precisely nowhere. Look at the time.
Did you hear that? There's a storm coming. Look at me. Extravagant. You wouldn't think there was a war on. Ted loves his egg custard. And between you and me, we don't worry too much about the rationing. Ted being a counsellor. You know, people are ever so appreciative. You can stay for supper, can't you?
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I suppose so.
It's been really nice you being here. We've never had a family. Well, I say that. Ted's brother's got kiddies, two daughters, but what with the war, we don't get to see them. Walter, this Seely Crescent you can't find, I mean, who lives there? Who are you looking for?
Relatives. Friends of the family, really. In fact, I should probably go soon. Keep looking.
Well, you can't go now. It's getting closer. Put those in the drawer in case they attract the lightning.
Can that happen?
Certainly. And while you're at it, put the milk in the meat safe while I throw a coat over the hall mirror.
Ted says I fuss, but you can't be too careful.
You have to start at the place where everything went wrong.
What happened to the siren? Feeling.
Why are you dressed like that?
We're trying to be inconspicuous.
I want to go home.
You've had a shock.
A shock?
Okay, you've had a lot of shocks.
I want to go home, Johnny.
I know. We all do. But we've got to find Wobbler first.
And stop Paradise Street getting bombed. And save Johnny.
Because listen, right? He doesn't even exist.
What are you talking about?
The best way to find Wobbler is to jump right on top of him. Think about it. How do we find Wobbler and get more time? We'll meet the trolley jumpers back to just before he ran off.
Start at the place where everything went wrong.
course, it's obvious.
Brilliant, but obvious.
Forget it. We're all going home right now.
Listen, listen.
Tell him, Johnny.
Listen! You've got to pull yourself together from it, okay?
I've been shot at.
Yeah, yeah.
By a soldier.
I know, but in a minute you won't have been. Because we're going to go back to before any of it happened. And all the bad men will have gone away. Okay? So stop wazzing about and get your hands on that trolley. Honestly, it's like herding cats.
I haven't had anything to eat, you know. I had that burger right, but Johnny made me leave most of it.
Instead of fighting amongst yourselves, I suggest you try and concentrate. Things aren't getting any better, Johnny, and you haven't got much time.
Yummy old mince every day I like. I bet you get sick of it.
I don't know. I don't think we ever have it.
Get away. You must do. Your mum never gives you mince. What do you live on?
We have burgers, I suppose.
Burgers? What are burgers?
Well, they're like mince, but mixed with onions, salt and pepper and stuff. They make them into sort of cakes this big. Then you fry them, grill them, have them on a bun with chips. They're brilliant.
Ooh, what a good idea. Whatever will they think of next? You know, Walter, if ever you need anywhere to stay, I know how it is these days. Families split up, bombs falling. Well, the offer's there. We've got a spare room. And you could show me how to make those burgers. That does it. I'm drawing the curtains.
Ah, here we are. Walter's Wobblers. The biggest and the best. I can personally recommend these.
Is everything all right, Sir Walter?
Our young friends will need the restrooms to change once their things are dry.
I'll see to it. Their clothes are in the microwave as we speak.
Most inventive. Then we'll need somewhere for a meeting, an important private meeting.
I'll talk to the manager. Will that be all, Sir Walter?
For the present.
Sir Walter?
Perhaps I should introduce myself, unless you've already guessed. Don't get me wrong, I bear no grudge. I was adopted by wonderful people, Councillor Seeley and his wife. Both long dead, I fear. They listened to my jokes, were amazed at my inventions, and gave me every encouragement.
We tried to go back for you, honest.
As I say, I don't bear a grudge. Of course, I can't speak for the people of Paradise Street. But as for you, Johnny, I think you should be more concerned for yourself.
You talk like it's all our fault. What did we do that was so terrible?
Paradise Street getting bombed. It's history. I mean, tough break and stuff. But what could we have done?
Nothing's fixed forever, Yoles. Remember that. Not even history. On the night of the blitz, there was a storm. It knocked out the phone lines, so no one could raise the alarm. Now, normally, the doctor would have driven into town.
Unless somebody wrecked his car.
So Tom was the last resort. He was supposed to ride into town on the police bike. Only the police didn't have a bike, did they, Big Mac?
You're stitching me up. I liked you better when you told crap jokes.
So no one gave the warning. And when the bombers came, the good people of Paradise Street were still asleep. 19 of them were killed, including Rose. So she never married Tom. They never had their children. And, of course, they never had grandchildren.
And that's why nobody knows me. I was never even born.
Yeah, but you said nothing's fixed forever. So we can still go back.
Yeah,
Save Paradise Street. Why not?
It must be worth a go.
Of course it's worth a go.
Johnny, that Big Mac's going to need careful handling. It's not just the going back. It's doing the right things once you're there.
And what about you, Bob? Sir Walter? If we find you, do you want us to bring you back?
Now, there's an offer. Do I want you to bring me back? Answer me this. What's the one thing a billionaire can't buy? Another life? Oh, can I face that large boy making crap jokes? I'll do it. Might be fun. I'll invent something else. Bigger than the burger.
Yeah, bigger than the burger.
Here's to it. Good luck, Johnny Maxwell.
We'll get all the way to Big Mac's house, and I bet he won't even come.
He has to come. It's no use without him.
Yeah, but say he won't.
Say he won't?
He will.
I have faith in you. You'll talk him into it. Us? What about you?
There's something I have to do. You take the trolley and I'll meet you back at the community centre. Even if I don't exist, I have to go home.
What are you doing in my house?
Simon! I know you're in there! Look, mate, if you don't talk to me, you'll end up talking to somebody else. Do you know what I'm saying?
His caseworker's after him. He must be hiding.
Careful! Step in there, we could both end up in the Stone Age.
What's happening now? It's all right. She's going. Come on.
I'm sorry. I know it looks bad, but I wasn't stealing. I know how important these things are to you.
You? What do you know? You know nothing. You're a young hooligan.
No, that gun's never worked. It's never fired a shot. I know you only keep it because someone gave it to you a long time ago.
Who are you?
On your case, is she?
What do you want?
To take you away from all this, back to 1941.
Forget it. I'm not going back there. I'm a wanted man.
Oh, yeah? And your point is?
Very funny. At least here, they don't try to shoot you.
We've all suffered, Big Mac. You're not the only one. Yolas were subjected to racial abuse, and I, myself, was a victim of sexism.
Big wow. This were a bullet.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, this close.
I know, but we've got to be strong. At the end of the day, we're doing this for Johnny.
And Wobbler.
And Wobbler, it's what friends are for.
You're wasting your time. There's nothing you or anyone else can say that'll persuade
Simon
me to...
Simon Wrigley!
Leg it!
Yamazuki!
I want a word with you.
Kirsty, for once, why can't you just leg it like everyone else?
Come on!
Oh, leave him, Jack. He isn't going anywhere.
Where did you get them?
Someone gave them to me. Long time ago. Queen of Hearts, right? Seven of Clubs. Easy. Ace of Diamonds.
You've learned them all.
Just like you did. You and the lads up on Blackberry Hill. They used to cheat, remember? So you never had a decent game. Isn't that right, Grant? Mr. Maxwell.
Who are you?
Me. Nobody.
Oh, don't give me that. Come on, you're here for a reason. Now, what is it?
I know the story. The one about Paradise Street. About you and Rose, the night the bombers came. There was a storm, wasn't there? And you were supposed to be the last resort.
I was supposed to raise the alarm. But someone had nicked the copper's bike. What could I do? I tried, but they were 3 miles into the town. I ran and ran, but bombers, they were right over that. I stood and I watched them bomb Paradise Street. All those people, my lovely, lovely Rose. Every day of my life, I've asked the same question. What could I have done different? Oh, it's like a pain, but deep in here. Oh, you'd never know, lad. You'd never know. Please, God, you never do.
Mr. Maxwell, I need to borrow these.
What for?
I want somebody to see them. Somebody who knows what really happened. Somebody who was there.
And what's done is done. It's ancient history. What difference would it make?
It might. You don't know. Nothing's fixed forever. Mr. Maxwell, please. What have you got to lose?
Nothing, I suppose. I know what's in that box.
I'll give it back to you. All of it and more. I promise.
You can run, but you can't hide.
Sorry?
3 von Trapps missing from the hampers. That's you and you. Where's the other one?
Dunno. Isn't he here?
No, and he's wearing my clothes. And what have you come as? Never mind. SS Various, that'll do. Covers a multitude of... Ah, the Wanderer returns. Marvellous. Well, what are you waiting for? Get him off. Chop, chop. And if I find that trolley is full of my props, you'll be hearing the sound of the screaming abdabs. Never mind the sound of music.
Come on. We've got to find Wobbler.
Concentrate, Johnny. Where your mind goes, remember?
Right, then. 2 pairs of leggings.
Landed on my phone. I think it's busted.
OK, I'll give you one last chance.
Look!
Who wants to hear a joke? What?
Grab it! No tidal waves.
So how does that work? We just stand around not doing stuff.
He's got a point. Shouldn't we at least go in and read the paper? Keep things like before.
Okay. This time when the doctor comes, you don't nick his car.
I didn't nick it.
So don't nick it again. Only better.
Shh. Who was that?
It's her. Johnny's gran.
What?
It's a long story.
Come on. Well, what do?
Do what you did before.
I wasn't here before.
Just stay with Big Mac.
Do you want to hear a joke?
Sorry, I have to read this. It's what I did before.
This is him. This is Dr. Harris. He's a doctor.
The clue's in the name, right?
Yeah, but it's like in the army as well. See, all this has happened before. This is the bit where he gets out of the car. He leaves the engine running.
Is there a bit where I tell you? I have no idea what you are talking about.
Shh! I know. There's a war on. I shouldn't leave her running, but you've no idea how long it took to get her started. I tell you what, you keep an eye on her for me. Evening, Mrs. Wilkinson.
Oh, hello, Doctor. Your tobacco, is it?
Yes.
So I'm just standing here, like this. Then I get in. I mean, I got in. Just for a look, you know.
Not going to do it now, obviously. And rolled off, all by yourself.
It rolled off, all by itself? Just like that?
Yeah, just like that.
Well, when's the bit where we do something?
My car! I say it! I say stop!
It's no good! Get out and jump in and drive it!
I'm not driving it, I'll get into trouble!
You're already in trouble! Look!
Oh, that's my car!
I mean, we just got a car.
What's going on?
Come on!
Who's in Gallagher? Come on!
Again?
What now?
Don't panic. We know what happens next. Stay cool and stick to the plan. There's a plan. There's a plan!
He's got a sort of Japanese thingy, sir. Not to mention this. Murderous lethal weapon.
You're in very serious trouble. You know that, don't you?
Tom! Let's go in.
I'm late. I'm supposed to be talking to Rose when the siren starts.
Whoa! Hold it there. Rewind, please. You're going to talk to Rose. And what happened last time?
I told her the truth.
I see. And she believed you?
Well, not exactly. She thought I was a bit gone in the head.
You don't say. Let's try something different.
Peace be upon you, Rose Bushell. My young associate here is gifted with the second sight and has a message for you. Please may we enter your humble abode.
Hello, and who might you be?
I think the gypsies, they said our abode was humble and then they just barged in.
Did they indeed? Well, humble or not, we don't need any clothes pegs, thank you.
Oh, we're not selling anything, Mrs. Bushell. We're here to give you something. We have a message for you. A message from beyond.
I'll throw them out, shall I, Mrs. B?
No, Tom, don't do that. Might be bad luck.
Oh, Mum, don't be so superstitious.
Just listen to that blessed thing. This is no time to be tempting Providence.
All right, say what you've got to say. You've got 3 minutes.
Something terrible's gonna happen tonight. Don't ask me how I know, you've just got to believe me. There's gonna be an air raid, but the warning won't be given. Loads of people in the street are gonna die.
Look, I don't know why you got these, but if there is an air raid, we'll get a warning, won't we?
Not tonight, you won't. Tonight there'll be a storm and the phones won't work. And before you say anything, Dr. Harris's car has already had an accident.
This is some kind of trick. Me and the lads have never had a picture taken. This is a fake. I don't know about you, but I say they've had the 3 minutes.
You don't want to do that? Johnny might be forced to give you the evil eye. It's the one on the left.
Please, Tom, don't upset them. We've got all the bad luck we need at present.
Good call, Mrs. B. Tell you what, why don't you put the kettle on? Make us all a nice cup of tea, whilst I have a little chat with Rosie. Maybe you could show me the backyard? Stinky boys, eh? Only know one way to settle anything, not like us. Leave it to the girls, that's what I always say. I like your frock, by the way. Listen, I know you think Tom's wonderful and he's like your last resort or whatever, but say, just say something went wrong.
Nothing's gonna go wrong.
No, but say it did. At least for tonight, would you promise me you and your mum would go into a shelter?
You're not a real gypsy, are you?
Come on, you must have a shelter.
Would you want to spend the night in there?
Oh, what's that smell?
I don't know and I don't want to know. If Tom says he'll warn us, then, well, that's good enough for me. He's never let me down and he never will let me down. You'll feel the same way too one day when you're a bit older.
About a bite? I don't think so.
Oh, come off it. Don't tell me you're not sweet on Johnny.
Johnny? No way. That's disgusting.
You're not a gypsy and you're not a very good liar. Look, I know you mean well, but honestly, you're wasting your time. If it's a choice between spending the night in the black hole of Calcutta and trusting my Tom, I'll go with Tom every time. Sorry.
I say, it's in colour.
Too clever by half.
Oh, sorry. Now, if I had a signal, I could send that to someone.
Really? Would that be someone on the network?
The network, yeah. That's right, whatever.
But first you'd need a signal. So what's this network, I wonder?
A network of Nazi spies. And he's one of them.
Oh, sorry, my line. I'm not a spy, I'm 15.
We've all heard about the Hitler Youth, haven't we, Sergeant?
Look at his haircut. Look at his clothes. Not exactly a Boy Scout, are you, laddie?
Oh, yeah, I am. Provisional wing.
Never heard of them.
Hmm. Military intelligence can sort this out. Lost property cover, please, Sergeant.
You did your best. Some people just don't want to have their lives saved. The bombers are coming, you stupid people! You're all gonna die!
Come on. Let's just hope Big Mac comes with the police bike.
Don't worry, he will.
What if he does something different?
No, trust me. If Big Mac's being shot at, he'll do exactly what he did the last time.
Doctor, have you ever had that feeling that things have, like, happened before?
Occasionally. I believe it's called déjà vu.
Déjà who?
Déjà who, sir.
Déjà vu. It's French for the already seen. Why'd you ask?
Well, funnily enough, I've seen all this before. For a start, I knew you were going to lock my stuff in that cupboard. And in a sec, that soldier's going to come through the door and say...
Cup of tea, anyone?
And you're going to say, excellent old chap.
Good grief, is that the time I've got to be on duty in half an hour?
No, hang on. You're supposed to say...
Pop Chummy in the cells, will you? Intelligence boys will be along later.
No, you're supposed to say, excellent old chap, don't mind if I do.
I'll give you excellent old chap. On your feet.
No, you don't understand. This isn't supposed to happen. Oh!
We can do. Maybe we're just going to keep making the same mistakes forever and ever.
Don't panic. Big Mac comes back, he's riding the bike. We just do what we did before.
Only this time we take the bike to Tom. I know.
So how hard can it be?
He's here.
Right, now remember, everyone, just do what you did before.
Sorry, Johnny. I've knackered the bike.
Come on, Big Mac. Come on, quick.
Certainly, if you please.
You're late, lad. Where have you been?
Someone hit the police bike. I had to walk. What's all this?
It's a chap from the papers. We're going to be in the Echo. Oh, come on, lad. They're waiting for you.
Me and the lads have never had a picture taken.
Thank you.
Manchester searchlights. It started. The bombers are coming.
Come on!
Dr. Harris! No, I'm Dr. Harris! I'm calling about my car. Yes, I know it's a mess. When will it be ready?
What the devil?
By Jove, you're the children from the shop.
Paradise Street is in terrible danger. The bombers are coming.
And you won't be able to warn anyone because you haven't got your car.
Tom hasn't got his bike.
And Storm's knocked out your phone.
But that's nonsense. I'm using the phone right now.
Dr. Harris, we know things. You've got to believe us.
Oh, man! Did you see that? Look!
Check out the date. It's tomorrow's Echo. That must prove something.
It proves Jerry will stop at nothing, using children as fifth columnists to sap our morale.
Or maybe it proves they're telling the truth.
That's baloney.
Sir, listen. That picture we just had done, well, I've seen it already. This afternoon, before it'd even been taken. Show them, Johnny.
Well, I don't understand. If you're saying what I think you're saying, then that means that...
Duh, they were, like, from 60 years in the future.
Kirsty!
So, get there quicker, honestly. Blokes.
Excuse me. Sorry. We were wondering if anyone liked to know. There's bombs dropping outside.
It's you. It's the spy. I thought you'd be involved in this.
I'm not a spy.
Right, get your hands up. I've had enough deja vu for one day.
Suits me. I've had enough of being shot at.
Come on, the lot of you. I'm placing you all under military arrest.
They're right about the bombs, sir.
10 miles to the west of us. Heading this way.
And these little blighters have sabotaged the phone.
Sack that guy. No way.
Doctor, there isn't much time. Whatever you think of us, you've still got to do something.
Sir, I could run into town and warn everyone. It's only 3 miles.
Could you? Good man, that's the spirit.
With the bombs 10 miles away, you'll never make it.
Wait a minute, Johnny. Where your mind goes, remember?
There is a way, Doc, but we'd have to go with him.
Really? What kind of a chump do you take me for? Maxwell, you get along. The rest of you, you get your hands up.
Well, I can do!
And you can pack that in for a start, young lady.
Sorry. I hate it when she does that.
Come on! Come on, hurry up!
Get off! Oh,
hurry up!
Cyril, do something now!
Hurry up, Big Mac!
Open this door!
Come on, guys, let's go! Come on,
open
Tom!
Open this door, I say!
Well, hurry up! We'll need at least 10 minutes, OK?
This is very serious.
Relax, guys, take it easy! But yup, the war is over.
Open this door!
Oh!
Tom!
What are you doing? We'll never make it with that thing.
We'll never make it anyway! Look!
The trolley!
You're mad you are. I'll get there on my own.
Honestly, folks. Oh. Come on, Johnny, we can't keep him here forever.
I think it's time for the old Shazam.
It sucks, but you get used to it. Come on.
Hang about. Listen.
What?
The bombers. They've gone.
You wish.
What do you mean?
They haven't gone, stinky boy. They just haven't arrived yet.
Look, 10 miles away.
I don't get it.
You will if we don't get to that siren.
We've gone back in time, stinky boy.
Now then, what's all this?
You've got to sound the siren.
Have I indeed?
The bombers are coming!
Oh, then I dare say young Tom will have the appropriate chitty from his commanding officer.
There wasn't time.
In that case, you'll be filling in form ARP 177. 4 copies. I hope for your sake we've still got some carbon paper. There is a war on, you know.
dead.
Hey, old Tom. You'll have it off the wall.
It's flaming dead.
Grab them, Constable. They've got no authorization.
Yamasuki!
Chill, poor Kirsty. Anger management. Remember.
There's going to be an air raid.
We've got to make it work. There must be a way.
Only by hand. We haven't done that in a while.
But you've still got the handle.
I suppose so. Somewhere.
Gallagher, you're giving away military secrets. Careless talk costs lives, you know.
No, it's faffing about that costs lives.
I beg your pardon.
Harry, lad, have you seen the handle?
What handle?
For the siren.
Oh, yeah, we did have one, didn't we?
Before the electricity, yes. Where is it?
Oh, now you're asking me. Let me think.
Get there quicker!
Shh! Please, we don't have much time.
Lost property cupboard, top shelf.
Sure?
No. Yes.
Come on, Sarge. We don't want to be the ones still filling in forms when Blackberry cops it.
Straight back to me when you've finished, Constable.
That's the kiddie.
Go on, hurry. The bombs will be here in a minute.
Move it.
Right then. Good luck, mate. Not me, Harry. Not on this leg.
Nay, don't look at me. I get dizzy on front step.
Oh, give it here.
No. Johnny, get there quicker, right? I'll do it.
Way to go, Tom. Look! Leave him. He's getting there as quick as he can.
This time it's the real thing.
Timmy!
Everyone, get to your shelters. You two, Rose, look after your mum.
Let's go, Mum.
Timmy!
Come on, love. No time for hanging about.
I can't find Timmy. I must have lost him. He must have run off.
Has anyone seen the dog? Anyone seen Mrs. Wilkinson's dog? Come on, you can't stay here. He'll be fine, he'll turn up, he'll be all right.
He won't. He'll think I've left him. I can't. What about me dog? Timmy!
Come along. Time for games is over.
It's incredible. They got there in time. How did they do that?
I think you'd call it a race against time.
Time just lost.
I'd never see you again. It was horrible.
Now then, put her down. You don't know where she's been.
Sorry, Mr. Bushell.
Don't talk daft, lad. I'm only joking. Here, let me shake the hand of a ruddy great hero.
See? I always said we'd be all right with Tom as our last resort.
It wasn't all down to me, you know, Rose.
Don't say that. We'll be famous. We'll be in the echo.
Well, they'll catch our deaths. I'm wet through.
Got to get out of these slippers. Come on now, Rose. We'll go and put the kettle on.
Be careful. Don't let anybody up the street. Not in there, you're not. I'm sorry.
Why not? We've not been hit.
Oh, yes, you have. UXB. There's an unexploded bomb in your... Excuse me, sir. No further. Thank you. There's an unexploded bomb in your cellar. Everybody must go up to the chapel. All of you. And wait until you hear the all clear.
A man dressed in little brief authority. Now then, are we downhearted? Are we echoes like? We're all here, aren't we? Thanks to young Tom Maxwell. Come on, follow me to the chapel. We'll have a sing-song. We'll meet again. We all know that one, don't we?
We'll meet again.
Don't know where.
Come on, Ida. There's nothing you can do.
Excuse me? Does anyone know where he lives?
Timmy? Oh, thank you, lad. What a good boy. See that, Harry Bushell? See what it's come to? I've got to rely on foreigners. Oh.
Don't take her seriously. She doesn't mean it.
I know. It was just the way she's brought up, right?
Aye. Aye, lad. That's about the size of it.
Quick! All join hands.
What are you doing?
Everyone wants to meet you.
No, I don't think that's a good idea.
It's turned into a big celebration. I couldn't have done it without you, Johnny. I'll never forget what you did, will we, Rose?
Never.
You celebrate for us, honestly. We don't belong here.
Here, take this. It's a brilliant souvenir, but I'm in enough trouble.
Come on, Johnny. We better be going.
Will we ever see you again?
I think so. One day.
Do you promise?
Yeah, Rose. I promise.
Stay right where you are. I've got one or two questions for you.
Flaming Nora.
I say, did you see that?
Get there quicker.
Yo, cool, what? We're getting good at this. Ah! Look at the state of these costumes. Quick, before someone sees them.
Right, then, two pairs of lederhosen. I don't believe it. What have you done? Your costumes. My costumes.
Excuse me.
Shut up. I don't know how you've done it. They're filthy. They're a disgrace. You're a disgrace. All of you. I've never seen anything like it. There's only one word for it I can think of. Totally, totally unprofessional.
Excuse me!
What?
Do you want to hear a joke?
A joke? Are you mad? I'm trying to throw a fit here.
Have a good one. Good man, Bobber. Well done.
Could you have your back, Bob?
How long have we been away? Years? Days? A few hours?
I know, it's weird. And all that war stuff, it seems kind of fuzzy, as if it never really happened.
That's because you weren't shot at. I was shot at.
Yeah.
With a bullet. Came this close.
Thanks. You know what I want when I grow up? My own chain of burger bars. Walter's Burgers. Brilliant. What do you think? You're right. Crap idea. Do you want to hear a joke?
Okay.
Are you serious?
No.
Not in this life.
Pass the ketchup.
Hello. Mum? Johnny, are you all right?
Mum!
Hey, hey, what's all this? What is it, love?
I've missed you.
But you only saw me this morning. Look at the colour of you. You look like you've been down a coal mine. Clothes in the basket and you in the bath. Hey, Johnny, does your granddad know you've got that?
He'll have a fit.
You best get it back before he misses it. Go on, I'll run your bath.
Oh. Hello, lad. Must have dropped off. Had a good day?
Yeah, Grandad. I've had a brilliant day.
Oh, Ev. Got something to show you. Found it at Beckett Drawer.
What's it for?
Well, the night of the Blitz. They reckon I ran 3 miles in under 10 minutes to give the alarm. What does it say? Thomas Maxwell, the last resort.
You were a hero.
Yeah, I must have forgotten about it. Must be getting old. I'll tell you something else. After the war, they wanted me for the Olympics. I tried, but, you know, I couldn't do it. No way. No way at all. And I promise you, I haven't done it since. The day you were born, your Grandma Rose held you in her arms, and you know what she said? She said it was like a promise being kept.
Johnny, your bath's ready.
Can I get you anything, Grandad?
No. No, I've got my health and strength. I've got you. I've got your mum. What could I possibly want?
Nothing, Grandad. Nothing at all.
Like a promise being kept.
I brought you these.
I don't want flowers, I want your shoes. They've hidden me slippers. Oh, right. Dinner, 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 dinner. Have these bags been opened?
Yeah, sorry.
Sorry? Sorry, I should Coco here today and gone yesterday. But you got a nasty shock, eh, Johnny boy? Did you leave everything nice and tidy?
I think so.
Good. I've got my reputation to consider. It's not just the going back. It's doing the right things once you get there. Someone I knew said that a long time ago. Oopsie doopsie, here comes old fart face. Gotta run.
Where will you go?
Who knows? Take life as it comes is my motto. And if it won't come, you go and fetch it.
What happened?
Where your mind goes, the rest of you is bound to follow.
Thank you.
Here comes the bogeyman. Don't let him come too close to you. He'll catch you if he can. Just pretend that you're a crocodile, and you will find that bogeyman will run away a mile. Say shoo shoo and stick him with a pin. Bogeyman will very nearly jump out of his skin. Hush, 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 here comes the bogeyman. Don't let him come too close to you, he'll catch you if he can. Hush, 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 here comes the bogeyman.